Hi everyone, and welcome you once again back to the channel. So in today's video, we are going to look at ternary operators. So when we talk of ternary operators, it is part of a conditional statement, and it's an alternate to the if-else statement. Okay, so we knew that the if-else statement works in such a way that we will have a condition, and then if the condition is met, we execute a certain set of statements. If it is not met too, we execute a different set. Okay, so basically we are going to have only two outcomes. So that's how the ternary operators also work. So it takes the form, like, you have the expression or the condition, then we have a questioning mark, then the first statement to be executed. If it is true, if the condition is met, then you have a colon, not a semicolon, a colon, then the second statement to be met, to be executed. If the condition was not met or it was false, then we have our semicolon to end the program. So let's take into, I actually had to make this a comment. So let's take an example, and I'm going to do something like a mark. So I create an integer score. Let's see that. Your score, see your score. Okay, so we have this program, and then if we were to use this normal conditional statement, that's the if else, I would have done if, let's say, score is greater than or equal to 40. Let's execute this. Otherwise, let's execute a different set of. Okay, so this is what we would have done for the simple if, but in this case, we have a shorthand for it. So as we saw over here, the expression comes followed by a question mark, and then followed by the first statement we executed, then the second statement. So this is how we are going to do. So I will do score is greater than or equal to 40. So that's our expression or the condition. Then, as denoted by the question mark, we do the first statement. So I'll do C out the U passed. You passed. Okay. So after this, we are not doing a semicolon, but a colon rather. So we bring the colon. So that one is actually representing the else. So we see out say you failed. Okay, so after this we can end our program, our statement. Okay, so this is how it works. So let's save this, go ahead, build and run. So we have here enter score, so I will say 50, and you can see we have you passed over here. Let's build and run again, and then enter score, I'll say 27. You see you failed over here. So it's basically a shorthand for a simple if else statement, right? So if you like the video, please do me a favor by subscribing, liking, sharing, also leaving a comment in the comment section. Let me know what you think about this video. Let's meet in the next video. Bye bye.